Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you two element antenna array. In my last video, I have explained an element antenna array. If you have seen that video, then in that I have derived electric field equation for an element antenna array. And based on electric field equation, I have explained you array factor calculation. In this video, I'll explain you calculation of electric field and array factor for two element antenna array. So here you can observe we have two element antenna array. This is element number one, that is reference element, and this is element number two. Here reference element, that is connected with zero phase, and the second element, that is provided with phase of alpha. Here these two are amplifier, and here we have power divider circuit. So here these two elements, that is radiating in space. Let us assume this antenna elements are radiating in this direction. Let us assume it is radiating in this direction. And this is antenna axis. This is antenna axis. With respect to antenna axis, let us say this angle is theta. So, but obviously this angle is also theta. Here, if you observe this element, which is reference element, so that is radiating in this direction. Even this element is radiating in this direction. But this element, that is leading by some phase, as it is radiating in this direction. But obviously signal from here will take less time compared to signal from this end. So here, see this antenna that will be leading by some phase. This antenna that will lead by some phase, and this antenna that will lag by some phase. Now, what is that phase difference? If you want to calculate that phase difference, then here you will have to have normal. See, from this line, you need to have normal. So based on this triangle, we can identify this path difference. And based on this path difference, we can identify phase difference. If you observe this angle is theta, this is diagonal, that is having spacing d. So this path difference, that is d cos theta. So here path difference in between these two antenna element, that is d cos theta. Based on path difference, we can identify phase difference over here. See, for lambda distance, phase difference is 2 pi. So for d cos theta, how much phase difference is there? So for d cos theta distance, phase difference will be 2 pi by lambda into d cos theta, right? The reason is, for lambda distance, phase difference is 2 pi. So for d cos theta distance, how much phase difference is there? D cos theta into 2 pi by lambda, right? So phase difference over here, that is 2 pi by lambda into d cos theta. And if you observe here with second antenna element, we are connected with phase of alpha, that is initial phase. So here I need to add that initial phase as well. So phase difference is sine. That is 2 pi by lambda into d cos theta plus alpha. So this sine, this value of sine, that is 2 pi by lambda is beta d cos theta plus alpha. So now we have phase difference, that is beta d cos theta plus alpha. Now here, see, with this antenna structure, if I consider here we have origin. If I consider here we have origin O. So what will happen? As if origin O is available over here, then this antenna element, that will be leading by how much phase? It will be leading by psi by 2 phase. And this antenna element, that will be lagging by how much phase? Psi by 2, right? So this antenna element, that will leads by psi by 2 phase, and this antenna element, that will lags by psi by 2 phase. So based on that, one can understand calculation of electric field. See, if I say this antenna element that is having electric field E1, so that has to be E0 into e to the power plus j psi by 2, where here this antenna element is leading phase by psi by 2 with respect to origin. And this antenna element, if I say it is having electric field E2, so that is E0 into e to the power minus j psi by 2. The reason is here this antenna element that is lagging phase by psi by 2 with respect to origin. Total phase is psi over here, right? So based on these two electric field, one can identify total electric field. So total electric field, that is algebraic sum of electric field due to element 1 and electric field due to element 2. So if you take E0 common over here, then we will be having e to the power j psi by 2 plus e to the power minus j psi by 2, that is total electric field. If you multiply and divide 2 over here, then this is cos psi by 2, right? So you can say total electric field, that is 2 E0 into cos of psi by 2, right? So here now we have total electric field equation, that is 2 E0 cos of psi by 2, right? And based on this total electric field, we can identify error factor. What is error factor? Error factor is total electric field divided by electric field due to one element, right? So let us identify error factor first. So here total electric field, that is 2 E0 cos psi by 2, right? And electric field due to one element, that is E0 over here. So this E0 that is getting cancelled over here. So error factor will be 2 cos of psi by 2 over here, where value of psi is how much? Value of psi is beta d cos theta plus alpha, right? So value of psi, that is beta d cos theta plus alpha. So here we have calculated two things. One is total electric field and second is error factor. And in this, one should know psi is beta d cos theta plus alpha, right? Now you might be thinking like, why I'm deriving it in this way? Already I have derived electric field and error factor for an element. If you have seen that, see, I have already derived electric field and error factor for an element. So based on this, directly we can identify error factor. Why should we go for a derivation? So if you take this error factor, then also we can derive same equation. Let me show it to you. See, for an element, error factor is how much? For n elements, error factor is sine of n psi by 2 divided by sine of psi by 2. That is what I have derived in my last video. Now see, based on this, one can identify this equation of error factor, where if you keep n is equals to 2, then we can have error factor of two elements that will be sine of 2 times of psi by 2 divided by sine of psi by 2. See, sine of 2 theta, that is 2 sine theta cos theta, right? So if you substitute that equation over here, then you will be having 2 times of sine of psi by 2 into cos of psi by 2 divided by sine of psi by 2, where see, this sine of psi by 2, that is getting cancelled, and we'll be having error factor for 2 element, that is 2 times of cos of psi by 2. So this is what the equation, this is what the equation which I have derived over here by basic standard process, right? So from an element even, one can derive same thing as I have shown it to you over here, right? And based on this error factor, one can identify many other parameters like location of maxima, location of minima, half power beam width, first null beam width. So all those things that I'll be going to explain you in next coming videos. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, then note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.